Hey guys, it's Nick. Welcome to another episode of T-365. If you're interested in getting best practice around Microsoft 365 security and also getting a bunch of enablement material for the security settings that you're implementing, stay tuned because in this episode, I'm going to be sharing a guide with you that I've created here based off of the SCuBA project from CISA that I've expanded. And I'm including a lot of that enablement material, such as the setup instructions, PowerShell scripts, video tutorials, and user notification templates that you can use as well too. And additionally, I've mapped that out to the CIS controls as well too, because I wanted a more holistic cybersecurity framework to follow versus just a standard checklist. So as always, if this content's helpful, go ahead and like and subscribe. Otherwise, let's go ahead and dive in. Okay guys, getting into it here, I'll link below my blog post here, which will link to the guide. And the premise behind this again is that I wanted to expand off of the SCuBA project from CISA, which came out many months ago now, but essentially it was kind of the government's recommendations on security controls across Microsoft 365 suite offerings. So I've done the same in here and I've expanded off of that to add controls that I believe are necessary for baseline, especially in SMB. But you'll see here in the contents, it spans across Azure AD, Microsoft Teams, Microsoft Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, and Intune as well. So I've expanded into the Intune sector and I posted last week on the channel about that because CISA didn't come up with any guidelines as it relates to Intune. So I wanted to publish this. And within this document, you also have a customer checklist as well too that relates to just navigating this within a Microsoft environment and having more of a condensed view versus this 190-page document here with all the enablement material. So as far as the content goes, I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this just for the sake of time, but essentially here it's broken out by looking at the individual description and kind of a why behind why you would want to implement the security control. Then it goes into policy definition is here as well too, things that you want to do as far as defining that within your organization. I cover license considerations here as well too. I'm sticking with mostly just the commercial common plans that most people get, but I do link at the top of the document the feature matrix you can click on as well too, which includes a lot more verbose information about the license breakdown across a lot more plans than just the high level ones that I highlighted here. But in here, I also included links where applicable for setup instructions and also the setup steps for various things that you might want to configure as part of these particular security controls. I'm talking about the end user impact here as well too, and I include some end user notification templates that you can access here as well and custom brand those. So whenever you're thinking about implementing these controls out to your organization, obviously one of the biggest things is the end user impact and the things that you need to outline in order for them to adopt the technology, number one, but also minimize disruption here as well too. So I've also included some tips just from my own experiences and just understanding the material a little bit better here from my own past exposure. And then I've included links to popular PowerShell scripts and video tutorials that either I've created or are very popular within the community here as well too. So just a lot of enablement there to get you going and get some more automation behind the things that you're doing potentially using PowerShell. So this is the format of the template here and the guide itself. So it walks through all the security controls and outlines all of these things here as well too. And then in the appendix section, I have more of that customer template or checklist that you can use as well. So the matrix itself is just the checklist across all the suite offerings that you see here that we go through. And it's everything that's in the guide, just in a condensed view here so that you can see that with some color codings for both the importance and the end user impact to give you a little bit more visibility into that. And you can go through here in your own tenants and provide the evidence of all the things that you're implementing, maybe some justification reasons if you're using a third-party tool, if you don't have the correct licensing, for instance, and then some more of that cybersecurity framework where you're reviewing and monitoring the policy on a periodic basis within the organization. I also have the CIS controls mapped here as more of a premium level offering that you can get as well too. You can see that up on my blog post. And this basically is just mapping all the CIS controls across all of the IG1 through IG3 segmentations here as well too, and then the various security functions. So I'm doing that across all of the suite offerings and everything that I've outlined in the guide where it's applicable, and you can have this as part of the guide here as well too. Lastly, I also included just a basic conditional access policy checklist. This is something that I feel like if you're a managed service provider and managing many tenants, it's not always clean cut as far as the reporting goes from the standpoint of mapping all of the compliance policies across all of your customers and knowing which compliance policies are which customer environments. There's obviously better ways to do this from an automation perspective, but this is kind of a template you could think about using here as well to document the various conditional access policies you have within your customer environments. So again, the guide's up here on the website that you can use and access for free. And then I have access to the CIS control mappings along with more end user notification templates. There's actually 48 total here that you can access if you go into the premium offering here, which is a paid offering that I've made that you can get as well too. It's all through Stripe, so it's a secure payment gateway, and then you'll get an email notification with that documentation in a few minutes after you've made the purchase. And then finally here, I'm also cognizant of the fact that it's really hard to maintain documentation around this just because things change so rapidly within Microsoft, and maintaining it via a Word doc, for instance, is not exactly scalable when we talk about versioning and me being able to share this with you longer term. So I'm in the process right now of building an application out that acts as a central hub for this documentation. And longer term, I do want it to be more of a crowdsource model where we can build in some moderation, things like that. But just a general concept right now, and I have a low fidelity mockup of what that might look like. But if you're interested in this and you want to provide more feedback, definitely check out a short form that I've created here as well too. It's only 4 questions and you can answer it really quickly. It'll help me understand a little bit better about some of the importance for you behind that and maybe some features you'd like to see as part of that being an application as well. Okay guys, that's everything I have for you in today's video. Definitely comment any questions or feedback below on the guide, things that you would like to see in the future as well. Otherwise, like I mentioned earlier, like and subscribe to the channel if you guys want to see more content around Microsoft and the MSP space. Thanks guys, have a great day.